impossible for you. There are no words or ways to show my love or all the thoughts I'm thinking.
Foundation, everyone, I am so grateful that you guys have taken out time of your busy day lives to join us. But unfortunately, your background, we can't hire you. So after a while, you give up and you know what? You got to survive. And I found myself back doing the same stuff that got me in trouble. And then a situation happened. I woke up and I said, you know, the system is set up to make us fail. There has to be something. From my own experience, I became a photographer, not because I wanted to. I had no other choice. I had to do something to provide. That's why you see all the photographs, the books, and working with all the different celebrities and stuff, is because I had no other choice. I didn't want to go back to prison.
Might I remind you too that it's all tax deductible?
Yeah.
So here you can give to others and still keep it for yourself.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying? So, and that way you're helping people while you're helping you, which is really what I think God meant for us to do. You know, it's always about give and receive. It's never been about give and give or receive and receive. It's about giving. That's what that whole circle of karma is about. And we hope that we turn the circle and karma into a spiral. So we don't just keep going a circle, but we keep lifting each other up as we go. And we can do that by helping other people. I've been blessed every time I've helped somebody. I don't do it to get a blessing, because if you're giving to get something, it's not a gift. It's a bargain.
Congratulations on this wonderful fundraiser. Everything that I've heard everyone say is so very true. You know, there's a lot of different ways of saying that the same thing that we're all saying is that, you know, give that closed fist. Nothing can get out, but nothing can get in either. That's something I remember as a kid. You can have that closed fist. I'm going to keep mine. But you don't receive when you have that closed fist. Just like Michael said, you know, it's a gift. When you give, it comes back to you twofold. I know that is a fact just from my foundation for sickle cell that I've been working at for 15 years. When I give, it comes back twofold, threefold, fourfold. So we have to be our neighbor's keeper. We have to be our brother's keeper, our sister's keeper. We have to just sometimes, you know, just a kind word, even though somebody's scaring you or making you feel like nervous, sometimes it's a kind word. How you doing? Good. Take care. Something like that makes a great difference.
I knew that I was just helping to propel your light and your energy and all the love that you bring. So I'm glad that we are in each other's lives. I'm glad I'm being a part of this. And I love these people that you have on this panel here, but they're yelling at me here to come back to work now, because I gotta yell action and cut it.
That was beautiful, Rocky. So well said. That was beautiful, son.
I surprised myself sometimes.
I know, every once in a while.
I love you guys.
We love you too. Thank you. Kiki, all right. Thank you so much. I appreciate you.
Thank you, Stephen.
You have been a blessing. I love your energy. And sister, nobody can dance and cut up on the floor like Miss Kiki Shepherd.
Don't tell everybody, Steve.
Okay.
And it's another thing altogether to take people into your home and to hold their hands and to show them the way and to give them hope in a better tomorrow. This has been an unbelievable time in all of our lives these past 2 years with living with the pandemic, having death be the undercurrent of everything day to day, people dying, the racial injustice of the last year that really obviously has been prevalent in our country from the very beginning, but that for many people, the events of the last year with George Floyd's murder and all the countless other police shootings and killings and people taking to the streets, I think it really opens the eyes of a lot of people. Once people come out of prison, to give them opportunity, housing, life skills, a path forward where they could secure employment and not spiral downward and return to prison. And so I just applaud you, Stephen, for your selflessness in wanting to address these issues and your faith in all that you've done already over the years. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of this evening with all your distinguished guests. I just gotta say hi to Kiki Shepherd, who I've been like watching on TV forever. It's such a pleasure to see you. But Stephen knows people from all walks of life. That's the thing that, you know, you help people, strangers you don't know on the street. And then a few hours later, you're hanging out with celebrities and photographing Tina Turner and all sorts of amazing stars. That says so much about your grace and your kindness of spirit and the beautiful person that you are, that no matter all the things that you've accomplished in your life and your shining example of how you've turned your life completely around, just inspires everyone. And so just grateful for you, Stephen. Thank you.
Thank you, Lisa. Thank you so much. I am so appreciative of you. And every time I've called and reached out to you, you've always answered. And if you couldn't do it, you gave a great explanation, but you always returned calls. You've called me, you've emailed me, and you gave me an opportunity to even photograph you. And I love the photograph that I have.
I'm Ross Stevenson. I had a 30-year career in the film industry as a publicist. And after many years at MGM and Universal, God bless me to have my own company. Stephen was on my staff, and we marketed to the African-American community for every major studio. During that time, I began to learn about Stephen's charitable work. I began to learn about how Stephen loves the Lord, and I learned how sincere he is in his outreach to those in need. Stephen is passionate about encouraging young people. He also is very serious about helping those who are trying to re-enter life after incarceration. And most of all, he is very much a person who looks to save souls for the Lord. That's his work. Over the years, I've done what I could to support him in his efforts because he is sincere, he's intentional, and he gets results. Stephen trusts God to lead him. He's unafraid to reach out when the Lord puts it upon his heart to help someone. It's a God-given gift, and he just loves giving back. As for me, I'm retired now, but Stephen is still in my life. He's like a son to me.
Thank you.
He's a very special child of God. I'm just pleading and begging for all of you to please donate to the Stephen Williams Foundation. Your blessing will bless those who in need. Stephen will see to that. www.stephenwilliamsfoundation.org.
Each of us is the word of God spoken only once. What a magnificent manifestation of God you are, Stephen. Your spirit of generosity touches me whenever I see you, always giving. Most people have a concept of poverty where they can do nothing but take. But you have a spirit of abundance, and you give and you give and you give, and it comes back, and it's such a joy to always be in your presence. I have to acknowledge my beloved Roz Stevenson, as you have spoken of, Roz. She is the absolute best, generous beyond compare, always giving, always showing up and supporting. And so I'm so happy to see Roz. And Roz, please give Robert my love. And you have Michael Keith Collier on here tonight. And very few reside in my heart more deeply than Michael Keith Collier. He's an exquisite human being who happens to be a man of great mirth, but he's a man of substance. And this entire panel, when I look at the variegated multiplicity that is represented here on this panel, high quality human beings, generous human beings. And so Stephen, I'm just so honored to be here. You know, I'm a fifth generation Angeleno. My great grandmother was born at 24th and Maple in 1890.
Wow.
And so I have watched this city change. I've watched it through the eyes of my great-grandmother. I've watched it through the eyes of my grandmother. my mother and father, and certainly even my older siblings. And the work that you're doing is so germane to the health and the entire Black and Brown community. The work that you're doing is so necessary. We hear the pejorative terminology of Skid Row. I've wanted to rename it the Hope District, because that's what we need to promote, hope. The recidivists, and I have any number of them in my family, the notion that you can come home, and even before you get home, to know that you're loved, gives you an opportunity to come back with some sense of integrity and dignity and a sense of feeling like a high quality human being. If you don't feel worthy, you cannot offer the world worthiness. And so Stephen, your encouragement along those lines, talking to young people, taking people in, it is just, again, germane to the success of our community, not just your life, because that filters out to all of us.
Not have the skill set to deal with what's going on around them. This is why everywhere we look, we see all these young people sleeping under the freeways. As Brother Michael said, sleeping in dumpsters and trying to be visible amongst people that consider them as invisible, as if we don't see them, as if they can be right next to us and we will choose to look another direction and instead of looking at them for who they are, humanity, God's image, and someone that requires us to respond to them. And so it's a very difficult and daunting task. And I thank God that you're willing to speak to it. Listen, what would we have if we chose to spend $300 million on homelessness each day, as opposed to spending $300 million in Afghanistan for 20 years every day? What would we have? See, it's not a matter of resources. It's a matter of will. And that's the difficult time. That's the issue of our prayer, is that our hearts change. Because if our hearts change, the resources will flow to address this place, right? To address this situation. We have children throughout Monrovia, Stephen, as you know, one of the biggest campaigns that I have is to address the issue of suicide and young people taking their lives. We have 9 and 7 year old children taking their lives.
World, when you consider what they're doing in, you know, to the Haitians down near the border of Texas. So I'm in. I've got meager budget, but I will make sure that every month you will see something that will go towards this cause, okay? And as you know, you've been a major part of my godson, my international godson's life, and he's growing exponentially because of some of your contribution to his life. You've been an encouragement to Elijah Jete, and now he's on his final year at Purdue University. He's about to kill it. He's also been promoted to a sergeant, I believe, first class. He's 27 years old. He's promoted to a sergeant in the military. And he has been offered a job at Microsoft. So, you know, all of these things come with the confidence that when someone shows confidence in these young people and some of the older folks as well.
There have been nights, you know, 10 years ago, Stephen and I would be on the phone and I didn't know where my son was at the time. And I would call Stephen, and Stephen would get in his car and go look for him. And there are times that Stephen just would, he says, guess who I have in the car? He would just call me, says, guess who I have in the car? And my son was strung out. And some of those pictures and photographs are my son. And now my son has turned over. And I know that, you know, the programs and the opportunity, it's really a mindset, right? Some of these, you know, I know my son, you know, I thought that, as a parent, I gave to him, I did the right things, but it's a choice. And then it is mental. And, you know, sometimes they go through a slippery slope, but through the grace of God and people like Stephen, when I met Stephen, I immediately, he was in attending UCLA, and I had an opportunity. I said, hey, you know, Stephen, I have a project. Do you want to come with me? And I'll train you. And he learned a whole new skill and all. And he has been very instrumental on many projects. And I'm just so happy, Stephen, that all the things that we've talked about, we've shared these moments on our what we want to do and how we can help. And so we actually have talked about, I work with Univer, I have a firm, Alliance for Student Aid Processing, and we have a multitude of opportunities. We work with universities and colleges and how they're trying to get, how they've changed lives. And many people ask, like, oh, do you want to own a college or university? No, I love what I do. I love to be able to go to different colleges, bring people with me that are talented, and we work on projects together and help university and colleges get through accreditation and federal funding for students. And now we want to expand. We want to expand it to where we're bringing people that maybe offenders that didn't have the opportunity to get them trained, to get them into a high paying job. It's there. It's all in education. And so I know I'm kind of scattered all over the place, but I'm just so happy right now just to see this. So please donate. Donating is important. What Stephen has in mind, thinks doors have been open, and you know that the Lord is in it.
Yes.
Okay. And now Stephen and I have been friends and colleagues for 15 years now.
People who were struggling on Skid Row. That was eye-opening. I had never seen anything like that. Of course, on the East Coast, we know about homelessness, but I'd never seen it in that magnitude. And so it's fair. We've hit upon drug addictions, and we've hit upon mental illness. But a lot of people that are on a day-to-day basis are misdiagnosed, or they're not diagnosed, or they're unaware that they have a problem. And I'm thinking of Michael Kenneth Williams. We just lost him. And, you know, of course, they stated it was a drug overdose. But, you know, who would have said to that brother, you are beautiful? And that's the one thing that I want to make emphasis on. When you did your book, Shades of Color, you're not only saying or recognizing Black men, but you're saying to Black men, you are beautiful. And a lot of times we as a people, we don't say that to ourselves. We don't get told that. And that makes a difference in our lives, that we are beautiful people, that we have a legacy that is beautiful. We're survivors. I lived in Ghana for 2 years. And immediately upon putting foot on ground in Ghana, I was told, we know fundamentally you're an American. You're different from us. I said, but my ancestry is from here. So that makes a difference. I say all of that to say this, is that a lot of times recognition is a big part of how we structure our lives. Belonging to organizations, being recognized in the community, being recognized in our churches. A lot of our young people don't have that. They don't have that bridge or that elder to say to them, you are important. And we've all seen the movie, The Help, where the maid speaks to the little baby and she says, you are important. That makes a world of difference in a child's life, to let them know that they are beautiful, that they are appreciated, that they are wanted. I'll end by saying that one of the things I hope to see in the outcome of the Stephen Williams Foundation is policy and legislature that will impact homelessness. I know Pastor Bell spoke on living arrangements, but I was a guest panelist with Susan Taylor about a year ago here in Washington, D.C., And she spoke in her new book about homelessness. And one of the things that she is a proponent of is having churches build facilities to meet the needs of people with homelessness. So dignity and integrity, to be able to have a shower and a hot meal, a place to lay your head. Why aren't our churches involved in that or engaged in that process? And if you come to the East Coast, my experience has been there's in one city, you have 10 or 12 churches in one vicinity of a city, and they're not addressing those issues. We have people who they want to crank their Cadillac and go home to their suburban home, and they come to church and they praise God, but they overlook the community that the church is in a lot of times. And so those are the things that are important. I hope to be an impact or provide input as well as donate to the Stephen Williams Foundation. And I'm blessed and thankful that you had me on here tonight.
No. Right? You let us know. I want to make sure you get a picture of everyone on here that said they're going to give. We're going to hold everyone accountable.
Take that photo.
Right. But listen, this is just the beginning, Stephen. So we need to have this conversation more often and pray that people will join and consider the value of the gift, the value of what that gift becomes once it's put into the work to change the lives that you're seeking to change.
And I'm proud of you.
Thank you. Thank you, brother. I am so glad. You know, God's timing is perfect.
Amen.
And I'm just grateful. Thank you, Lisa. Thank you, James Moss. James, did you want to say anything? Are you good? Mr. Moss, before we say goodbye.
Oh, hey, Stephen. For some reason, I thought you said David, but you know, it's been a blessing to actually listen to everyone speak on here. And it's been a blessing for me to know Stephen. So now I have to, I'm compelled to do a monthly donation to Stephen's Foundation because Stephen has helped me in just listening sometimes.
Yeah.
Not because I have an addiction problem or homelessness, but Stephen has a heart and an ear that doesn't seem to wear out sometimes. But more than that, he always prayed. And that made a difference. But I'm glad to have been included, invited. Hope to meet all of you one day. But yeah, we absolutely have to make a difference. You know, as you said, Susan Taylor spoke of churches doing that. And so, you know, well, the church is within us.
Yes.
And so maybe we have to show the church how to do it.
That's right.
You know, so, but blessings and love to you, Stephen, for everything that you do selflessly.
That's right.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm going to churches right now and get a two-piece and a biscuit.
Churches? Yeah, I need the Popeyes. Okay.
So listen, everybody.
I love y'all. Good night.
I love you. I appreciate you. You made my day. You made my year. Thank you. Thank you so much. Love you all.
I love you, Stephen.
Love you. Big hug. All the way to the UK.
Stay vertical.
Rocky.
I sure will, brother. Sisters, thank you. Thanks for your gift. Thank you for your gift. God bless.
God bless.
God bless you.
Love you.
I love you, Stephen.
I love you too.
Hi, this is Richard Hartley. I'm here on the set of my latest movie project, Lock Party, with John Amos and Linnell and Margaret Avery. But I'm here to talk about my good friend, Steve Williams. As we all know, he's the greatest photographer in the world. And not only a photographer, but he's a philanthropist, a community activist, and he cares about the homeless, and he cares about people. So I want you to support his event. on September 24th. Look for it at Steve's Image. That's Steve Williams, our best photographer. This is Richard Hartley. All the best to you, brother.
Hi, I'm Marcus Patrick, and I'm endorsing Stephen Williams Foundation from the heart, because I've known Stephen for more than 10 years. I don't even know how long, but when I was working my entire 12 to 15 years in the Hollywood scene and focus, and he was my favorite photographer, still is my favorite photographer, because we were able to talk about deeper issues than just the superficiality of looking good in the pictures, you know? And Stephen's character, Stephen's spirit is, it's an epic, beautiful one. It's almost angelic. And I have no doubt that his foundation is gonna help a lot of people, help society, give the people a lot of hope. So I'm supporting him wholeheartedly, both in financial support and in moral support. And I advise you do too, because Stephen Williams is a rare person, rare breed. Good luck, and enjoy all of the festivities of the event.